Prior to entering politics, DeSantis served in the Navy as an attorney at the U.S. prison at Guantanamo and in Fallujah, Iraq. DeSantis's time at Guantanamo is coming under scrutiny after a former prisoner revealed that DeSantis had personally witnessed him being force-fed and tortured. Other prisoners have backed up Adayfi's count. Well, yes, Mansoor Adayfi is a former Guantanamo prisoner, imprisoned without charge for 14 years and 7 months before being released in 2016.
In 2006, when Ron DeSantis was there during the torture by the force feeding, a group of officers arrived with the interpreters, with the interrogators, camp staff, medical staff. They were behind the fence, and I saw one of them was Ron DeSantis in a military uniform. And he was, while I was screaming, yelling, because I couldn't breathe of the insure, and was like, I was bleeding because they really insert a thick tube through my nose. So I was like calling them, asking, and he was actually laughing, looking at the other officers and smiling. And if you ask me, I think DeSantis is a cruel person. I believe that his mission there was a cover up. I didn't see him giving orders to the guards, but he was there supervising, watching. When I asked other prisoners who were also in the first feeding, if they saw him, they said yes. One of them, at least, he told me, he sent me a message. He said he was there too. I got fed 5 times a day. They left me all night on the first feeding chair, and they give us some kind of laxative liquid in the nutrition liquid. So while sitting on the force feeding chair, we would shit in ourselves, and they left us like that.
Last month, DeSantis denied authorizing force feeding at Guantanamo.
The Washington Post did a big deep dive on this today, actually, about what you did out there. One of the things they said was that you authorized the use of force feeding.
That's
some of the
true. Yeah, that's not true. Yeah, any of the stuff that people
just to finish it, force okay. feeding to detainees who were on hunger strike, was that true?
So I was a junior officer. I didn't have authority to authorize anything. There may have been a commander that would have done feeding if someone was going to die, but that was not something that I would have even had authority to do.
So that's wrong.
Yeah, absolutely.
That was Ron DeSantis last month in an interview with Piers Morgan. But in an interview 5 years ago, in 2018, DeSantis admitted to CBS Miami that he'd authorized force feeding.
I was a legal advisor.
For those that were doing
the things that would happen is the thing you notice the day you get down there is for these detainees, the jihad was still ongoing. And they would wage jihad any way they can. Now they're in a facility, so it's limited, but some of the things they would do hunger strikes. And you actually had 3 detainees that committed suicide with hunger strikes. So everything at that time was legal in nature one way or another. So the commander wants to know, well, how do I combat this? So one of the jobs of the legal advisor would be like, hey, you actually can force feed. Here's what you can do. Here's kind of the rules of that.
I was tied to a force feeding a chair. Like, I couldn't move at all. I could only breathe. Guards bring piles of insure. And they started with the nurses pouring can of insure one after another. Like on one of the first feeding, when I was like throwing up, Ron DeSantis was there behind the fence, and camp officers, they were behind the fence. When I was throwing up, the insure was too much in my stomach, so I threw at them, and they jumped back. They was killing themselves looking at me. So I felt I did something at least, you know, worth it. So I would like to say one word to Americans: just watch out from that person. You know, is someone who bend the truth to serve his own political interest.